Good evening and welcome to Horizon. I'm Ted Simon. Senator John Kyl will not be running for re-election next year. Kyl announced his decision today, a decision that throws the 2012 race for the Senate seat, his Senate seat, wide open. We'll hear from a political analyst about the fallout from today's announcement, but first, here's some of what Senator Kyl had to say about his decision at a news conference this morning.
I will not seek re-election to the United States Senate, but will retire from public service in January of 2013. Let me hasten to say that there is nothing negative about the decision that I'm making. My health is good. I think, I'm fairly confident that if I ran for re-election again, that I could be re-elected. I do not subscribe to this notion that politics has gotten so coarse these days that civil people can't engage in it. I try to do it civilly and learned long ago that there will be people who don't engage in civil discourse, but if you stop that from serving, then you really ought to get into another line of work. So that there's nothing about that that causes me to step down.
And here now to talk about the politics of today's announcement is Chris Herstam. He served as Governor Fife Symington's chief of staff and is a former lawmaker. Herstam now works for the law firm of Lewis and Rocha. Good to see you again. Thanks
Good
for
evening,
joining
Dad.
Us. This is a surprise.
I wasn't surprised, simply because I had talked to a staffer of Kyle's several years ago, frankly, right after he got reelected last time, 4 years ago, and there was sort of a feeling then by this staffer that that was going to be his last election. So I think some people very close to Kyle sort of had a clue that last election was going to be his last one. So when the rumors were going around the last couple of months, I sort of had come to the conclusion that he would probably announce his retirement. Why he picked this month, I don't know. Why he did it this early, I don't know. I think he mentioned in his comments in the news conference that he wanted to give potential candidates a lot of advance notice. So I think we have to take him for his word.
There, the internal Arizona politics, especially on the Republican side right now, it seems like it's pretty rough and tumble, a couple of sides kind of going after. Does that play at all any part in how he could see himself as a leader here in the state and moving that forward? I mean, did he see any problems there?
Well, you have to remember, Kyle endorsed Ron Carmichael, who was running for state chairman. Most of the Congress people did, and he was beaten, frankly, at the state party convention. The more of the Tea Party element or the grassroots element that actually had been against McCain for many years, they came out against Kyle's candidate. And so he played that game. Frankly, I think that was another tip-off that he wasn't going to run, because normally Kyle is cautious with regards to internal party politics, but he stuck his neck out in that race for party chairman, lost, his candidate lost, but I think he did that because he knew he wasn't going to run anyway and it wouldn't cost him anything.
Interesting. Okay, is this a precursor to anything else? I know today he said he wasn't interested in president. Vice president still seems to hang out there a little bit. Anything going on here as far as future ambitions?
Well, he's been a U.S. senator now.
Yeah.
And been in Congress for, as of that next year, 26 years. Can't do much better than that, frankly, except running for president. And he said he wasn't interested in that. He's always said, he has said for the last year or two, that if somebody wanted to put him on the ticket as vice president, he'd do that. But once again, I think what you see is what you get, and what he says is accurate. He's been in Congress almost 26 years now, and I think he just wants to do other things in life, family things. He's a big NASCAR fan. He can travel the circuit if he wants to.
What will John Kyl's legacy be? I mean, he still has some work to do, and it sounds like he's all gearing up now, knowing he doesn't have to campaign again. He's going to be pretty active. But until we know that, until now, what do you think?
I think he's done some excellent things for the country as well as the state with regards to water and water law and reform and so forth and some important agreements. He's always been a water expert even before he got into Congress. As an attorney, he was. John Kyl is a senator's senator. He doesn't grandstand. He isn't interested in, the interviews and the media. He can do it very well, but he really works behind the scenes, is a detailed-oriented individual, rational. He's very conservative, but he's easy to deal with. He can work with both sides of the aisle. He's just a class act, and that's what Arizona is going to lose so much of.
All right, let's try to find out what Arizona will get once he does step down and the new senator is elected. We can spend all day listing the names, but give us, handicap some early favorites.
Probably every elected official in the state of Arizona is thinking, gosh, I'd like to do this. But I think when you look at the sensible contenders, you look at the congressional candidates that are in Congress right now. Jeff Flake would be a leading candidate. Trent Franks might think about it. John Shadegg, who left and retired from his congressional seat, I think will eye the seat as well. So I think that congressional group will be very interested. Also, there's a new guy on the block named Ben Quayle. That may be thinking about it too. There was always some articles written about how his dad had done some fundraising for him and had made the comment he may be in the U.S. Senate sooner than you think, as he was fundraising for him. So did they know something? I don't know.
Any dark horses out there? Anyone that people aren't necessarily looking at first?
Yes, I think there is a dark horse, and somebody that would be very formidable if you wanted to jump in the Republican primary race, and that's Senate President Russell Pierce.
Interesting. Say more, please. How formidable.
I think, in a low turnout Republican primary where the immigration issue is critical, if Russell Pierce wanted to get in this race and it was a crowded field of Congress people, and he's got the Tea Party Senate and he's leading the Tea Party movement and the grassroots workers that we just talked about that defeated Kyle's candidate, they're big fans of Russell Pierce, I think he'd be a very fascinating candidate. Now, whether he wants to do that or not remains to be seen. There's rumors that Sheriff Joe is not going to run again, and he's always been interested in the sheriff position. So I think Russell Pierce may have lots of options the next election cycle.
Governor Brewer a possibility?
She'd have to resign.
Sure.
To run.
But then
and I just think she's more state-oriented. She's got a full four-year term here. I can't see her leaving that the governor's office and going to Washington like the last governor did.
Well, let's talk about that last governor. Let's get to the Democratic side now. And obviously, her name is first on the list. How likely is it that she would run?
I think it's very unlikely because I think she would simply read the tea leaves and realize she can't win. When she left and made the decision to go to Washington, she became part of the Obama administration. Obama is probably going to lose Arizona in 2012. And once again, with the immigration issues and the health care issues and Arizona suing and so forth, I think it would be hard for Napolitano to wear that Obama cloak around her and be successful in a statewide race. Now.
Okay, some other names. Terry Goddard, Phil Gordon, Jim Peterson. Will those names be around?
Sure. But the Democratic bench is not very deep. And so they have to turn to people that have run and lost already. That always tells you that they don't have a lot of up-and-coming candidates. And that's probably one of those names you just said, maybe the very likely Democratic nominee.
Last question. Let me ask you, is there any dark horse on the Democratic side, someone we're not thinking about right now?
The only Democrat that I can think of that would be a sure winner would be Gabrielle Giffords. But obviously, we don't know how long that recuperation period is going to be. The odds are sort of would tell us that because a Senate campaign would start a year from now, that she'll need more time to do that. But if her miracle recovery continued, she'd be unbeatable.
Wow. Interesting stuff. Chris, good to have you here. Thanks
My
for joining
pleasure.
Us.